Welcome, everybody. Tonight, you're going to see something amazing. It's something that, you know, we at Star Trek Records have been very excited about. And, you know, there was, I don't know. Of course, DA would want me to sit here and tell you how much of a crazy bidding war there was for them. As everybody in here knows, DA. But you know what? He's right. And if you think about it, you think about where they come from and okay. It's funny. But you know what? Think about it, man. Like, Harvard grads? And then on top of that, there really was a bidding war, and it really was incredible, and we really lost our minds, and you're really about to see a great, incredible show, and you should really, really, really give it up for, what's the name of the band again? Who? Absolutely. Let's do it.
In today's world, style gets you far, but swagger gets you much farther. That's what Dirty Jacks lives by. They say if you grab their t-shirts or hoodies and clothing, you get instant swagger, and that makes them stand out from everybody else. So make sure you check out Dirty Jacks. Now, another group that's all about their swagger is Chester French, their newest pop act that Pharrell and the Neptune signed. Need I say more? Check out this interesting interview. Man, Jeremy Hassel, the original grown-ass kid, with two guys right here, Chester French. What's your guys' names? Introduce yourself.
I'm DA. I'm from Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Max, I'm from Boston.
Okay, now here at Gak City, we always argue about music, what's going on, anything new, something good. Now, Lemieux Coker told me about you guys. I was like, what's Chester French? What is that? Then I go and I interview Janelle Monae, who's an amazing artist, and she tells me I love Chester French about 6 months ago. So I've been chasing you guys since. Finally got to here in New York. Now, let's go back to what is Chester French, man?
There are a lot of lonely people who are sleeping in the city tonight, and they've been lining up outside the club and looking for a love that is right, is right.
And if you want... Chester French is what we do. It's the two of us, and we've been doing it since our freshman year of college. We started with a few other guys, but then for the past 4 years have been doing Chester French as the two of us. And just recently put together an incredible live band who's going to be playing with us tonight as well, which is three other friends of ours. So Chester French Live is like sort of all five of us, or we call them the pervs sometimes, and we're Chester French, or, you know, but it's really the two of us.
Wow. How did you two even meet?
J-Date.
J-Date, it's a dating service, you guys don't know. It's a great thing. You guys went to school. Where did you guys go to school?
We went to Harvard and graduated in June of 07. So we've been out on our own for almost a year now.
You guys start playing music. How did you guys even start playing together?
Well, we had both played in high school. I was a drummer in high school. Max played guitar, and both were sort of focused on jazz stuff in high school, but always listened to all kinds of music. And once we got to college, I think, you know, we didn't have necessarily determined plans to be in a band, but, you know, we certainly both wanted to continue making music, or, you know, being involved with music in some capacity. So, you know, we just met with these other dudes freshman year, and it was like a fun thing. It was almost like a joke band to start off. Like, we would just do, what we do, we had songs about sort of medieval knights and, like, really, you know, I was kind of out there, and we would play mainly on campus for our friends, and that's how it got started.
But you feel so clean.
Ow. Looking at you guys got some labels looking at interest. How'd that even start? Like, Jermaine Dupri, Kanye West, how'd that even come about?
Well, we finished we were trying to make our record on our own from sophomore year to senior year. And the idea was that, you know, we'd finish this thing and we'd hopefully, you know, put it out ourselves, or someone, you know, really thought it was great, maybe, you know, an indie record label or something would do something with it. But we finished it, and just in looking for someone to mix it or to talk about distribution or whatever, we started sending it out to like as many people as we could, and sent it for about a year to like as many people as we could get it to. And you know, eventually it just clicked.
And you guys ended up signing with Star Trek, which is the Neptunes label, Pharrell and Chad. Why'd you guys pick them?
Well, Pharrell's Max's dad, so it was like a natural, it was a natural thing. And you know, also on a business level, we're very greedy, and we have a one-track mind, you know, the two of us collectively, that is solely oriented at, around money and you know, conspicuous consumption, whatever. We talked to those guys about it, and we said, look, this isn't really about music, is it? And they said, no, it's not. This is about partying. So
when you guys were actually working on your record, your debut album coming out now, how much work did the Neptunes have with you guys in the studio? What was it like?
Nothing. When we did our deal, it was really important to us that we would remain the sole producer of this album, and that when it came out, it would truly be the album we had made in college, like on our own, without all this help. And they've been great in terms of listening to the music, giving us their opinions on it, advising us as to like what songs they would choose to put on it if it were their record. But at the end of the day, we've had, you know, pretty much complete autonomy, which has been amazing.
That's amazing, especially for a new artist. Well, so what's the sound? What's the record gonna sound like?
Perfect.
What's your guys' lifestyle like, man? What are you guys doing every day?
I usually, you know, I start every day with an 8-ball and a blowjob. And, you know, proceed from there. Sometimes you want to make music, you know. Sometimes, you know, I saw, you know, Grand Theft Auto, the new one came out. And since that came out, I've been committing a lot of acts of just wanton violence. Day in, day out. And, you know, it's awesome, just drug-fueled rampage. In Los Angeles mainly, because that's where we live, but also my parents live in Boston. And, you know, like, they're pretty accommodating of that lifestyle.